Coming up on NBA TV Daily, all eyes were on the Western Conference. The number one seeded Spurs and Tim Duncan took their perfect rodeo road trip to the Q to battle LeBron and the Cavaliers.
LeBron in full flight! Flight number 23! Exploded off the runway!
Right on their heels are the Dallas Mavericks, and they look to start a new winning streak at home against the Knicks. And the surprising Hornets look to make it 3-0 without their floor leader as they hosted the Wizards. We know the way to your heart. Right here on NBA TV Daily. This is Ron Burke, and we begin this Valentine's Day Daily in Cleveland, where Tim Duncan and the Spurs were looking for love in the form of a 10th straight win on the road against LeBron James and the Cavaliers. Here's Duncan getting it back from Michael Finley, and Duncan with a nice fadeaway connects perfectly. Now here is James dribbling up. He'll slash the basket, and it's about to get loud in there. He throws it down. After one, it was Spurs 19-18. Here's James knifing his way inside, dropping it off to Z-Man Ilgauskas for the stuff. Capping the 15-4 Cleveland run. Now it's Duncan working at the other end. Jump hook and the foul. Spurs down two. Here's James again. Look at the deal as he goes inside again. Challenges that Spurs defense and scores. Cavaliers up 45-44 at halftime. LeBron beginning to crank up that game. Step it up, behind the line. That's a three, Cleveland by six. James here breaking down the D, taking it inside, left hand in. Now it's James working the baseline on the reverse side. He had 18 third quarter points alone, Cavaliers by nine after three, and LeBron keeps bringing game in the fourth. Low and pass Michael Finley, then with the give me the ball, taking it the distance. Cleveland builds a 17-point lead there against the Spurs. LeBron James had a huge night and some style points to go with it as the Cavaliers win this game 101-87, styling and profiling as LeBron James, whose 44 points led everybody. More on that in a minute. It was his sixth game over 40 this season. The Spurs franchise record 9-game road winning streak ends. The win moves Cleveland to an impressive 14-2 at home against teams above 500. What a night for James, 19 of 33 from the floor, and amazingly, 22 of his 44 points came in the paint. The 44 points, the most scored against the Spurs this season, topping the 43 that Gilbert Arenas put up against San Antonio in November. In fact, LeBron's outburst was the most against San Antonio since. The answer is the answer. Allen Iverson dropped 46 February 12th of 1999.
It was a great win. You know, guys were mentally focused. I seen it in guys' eyes. They got up to a quick start, but I mean, it didn't discourage us or nothing. And we did a great job executing offensively and defensively, and we won a big game, real big game. Tonight was one of those games, you know, going into the All-Star break, you know, it's guys tend to slack off just a little bit before All-Star break. I don't know why, it always happens. But I wanted to come out aggressive tonight, get my team rolling, and I did a great job of doing it.
I had a tough transition. Coming here from Miami, having to come off the bench, it was a tough situation, and I think for the most part, you know, mentally it was a little tougher than I expected, and you know, sometimes when you don't have your head in the game, most of the time you're not going to play your best basketball. But you know, I understand, you know, for us to be a good basketball team, I have to come off the bench, and you know, I'm accepting that role, and you know, I'm starting to play a little bit better.
Well, it wasn't all good for the Cavaliers. They did get some discouraging news Monday. Guard Larry Hughes will have a second surgery on his broken right middle finger. The procedure will take place today. The team did not say how long he'll be out. Hughes was supposed to miss 6 to 8 weeks after having the first surgery January 6th, but doctors determined the finger had not healed as quickly as the team had hoped. Elsewhere on the NBA schedule, Monday, the Mavericks home to the Knicks. No Marbury, no Jamal Crawford because of injuries. Avery Johnson and the Mavs looking to bounce back after their 13-game win streak was snapped. Dallas owning a 9-game winning streak at home. Josh Howard with a miss, not to worry. Adrian Griffin gets it out to Jason Terry for three. And Terry had 12 and a half. Malik Rose now gets the feed from Jalen Rose. A Rose is a Rose. and it scores. Now it's Terry with the penetration move, and he will kick it out to Josh Howard from three territory. Howard had 10 points in the first quarter, 12 and a half. Now it's Devin Harris with the drive, the spin, out to Keith Van Horn for three. That caps a 14-6 Dallas run to end the first. They're up 10 after one. Mavericks extend the lead in the second. Marquise Daniels crossing up, Quinton Richardson, and finishing. It's a 15-point Dallas advantage. Mavericks running here, Terry to Dirk, who does the work. The lead is now 20 in the second. Knicks trying to stay in this thing, to move it in transition, get it to Richardson here, who scores. He had only 12 points this game, and the Knicks were down 15 at halftime. Dallas continues to force the issue. There's Dirk running it. Here they come. Josh Howard getting it from Nowitzki, scores. Good for a 14-point lead. Now it's Nowitzki spinning inside. We'll get out to Jason Terry, who buries the long ball. Terry was 4-5 from beyond, and now it's Young, Gifted, and Stackhouse driving, hitting the short baseline shot. Stackhouse had 10 points in this game, and the Mavericks have points from all over the place. They win 100-72. Nowitzki's 21 lead, six Mavs in double figs. Dirk a perfect 11 for 11 from the free throw line. As a team, Dallas shot 34 of 37 from the line. The Knicks' nightmare season continued. They've lost 10 straight and 16 of 17, and so the Knicks continue to struggle. A special welcome for those of you watching us through a free preview. NBA TV is your all-access channel for everything basketball. Call your service provider to receive NBA TV full-time. We now go back to the action. And the Lakers, fresh off another one-point loss to the Grizzlies, took to the Staples Center floor against the Utah Jazz. Utah had not had much success in L.A., losing 8 of its last 10. The bigger picture, though, had the Jazz a half game back of the Lakers for the 8th and final playoff spot in the West. Lamar Odom and the Lakers looking to be successful on the home floor. Here's Kobe Bryant, early on playing some tough D. He got 6 steals in the first half. That ties the Lakers record. With time running down in the first, it's Kobe drawing the double. He'll drive, he'll fade away. Most importantly, he'll hit. Lakers up 21-13 after one. Jazz having trouble scoring. Lakers breaking in the second. Kobe, the no-look at a smush Parker. It's smush with the smash. The lead is 20. Now it's Lamar Odom to Bryant. Sizes up a three. It fits perfectly. Lakers up 50-32 at the half. In the third, Devin Brown D'ing up Bryant, but he pulls up and knocks down the three. Hard to guard. Jazz try to make a game of it. Mil Palacio giving it to Brown. And he drives to cap a 12-2 Utah run. They got within 9 there. Now it's Mil Palacio to Matt Harpering, who gets the leaner and the foul. And the Jazz are within 8. With time running down in the third, it's Bryant getting it to Sasha Vucevic. And he buries the outside shot. Lakers by 13 at the end of 3. Darren Williams stripped by Smush. And Parker takes it in with a posterizer. The lead there was 15. Now it's Williams driving, and you know what? Gets tripped by Kobe Bryant this time. Lamar Odom getting it ahead to Smush. Back to Odom. Everybody get a touch. Kobe Bryant had a career-high 7th steal on that play, and the Lakers win it 94-88. Kobe finishing with 23 and a career night in the takeaway department for him. Bryant Cook continued his solid play with 15 points, 4 boards, and 2 rejections. Devin Brown's 25 for the Jazz, a career-high for him, as this loss came 1 year after the legendary Karl Malone announced his retirement. We're going to retire, but just briefly. When the Daily returns, we'll have highlights from Oklahoma City as the Hornets look to make it 3 straight against the Wizards, and the Warriors are home looking to extend the Grizzlies' recent misery. Stay close. This is NBA TV Daily. Welcome back. The Hornets hope to have Chris Paul back in the lineup last night as they took on the Wizards. The outstanding rookie had missed the previous 2 games with an assortment of bumps and bruises, mainly to his ribs. Speedy Claxton had filled the void well, though, leading the Hornets to wins over the Knicks and the Timberwolves. But neither of those teams featured a high-scoring point guard like the Wizards, Gilbert Arenas. First things first, the status of Chris Paul. Relegated to spectator duty, Mucci Norris was acquired by the Hornets for Marty Lampe on Monday. The Eastern Conference Player of the Week is Gilbert Arenas. How would he cap that day? But Washington build a 12-point lead after one. Antoine Jameson kicks it up there in the second to a 13-point advantage. Then it's Arenas spotting up with a long three. And at halftime, the Wizards were up 17. Here's Arenas now in the third drive and getting the tough stuff to fall. Washington plus 11. Kirk Snyder now comes up with a steal. Kirk Snyder is on his way somewhere. Surveys the field, says, I can take it. And he does. Makes it a 10-point game. David West now getting it down low. He will spin against Etan Thomas and throw it down, part of a 12-2 Hornets run. They're down only three after three. Here's Arenas driving the fourth pass, Rasul Butler, and the Arenas does it. Washington by four. The Hornets erase a 19-point deficit. 19 points. That's Aaron Williams, putting them up 85-84. Speedy Claxton, who fed Williams on the previous play, now locates David West. It's a 5-point lead. Time running down in this game. Antoine James, he'll recover the loose ball in the corner. His jump shot is clutch with a half second to go in this game. Washington by one. But the Hornets have a chance. Down one, half a tick. They get off a shot. And it's David West nailing it to win it. Turn out the lights. In this case, the light turned on just after he released it. It counts. And the Hornets beat the Wizards 97-96. David West game winner. His third this season. His earlier last second shots came January 30 against the Bucks and December 28 against the Rockets. In the loss, Gilbert Arenas was sensational. He topped the 40-point mark for the seventh time this season. The reigning Eastern Conference Player of the Week shot 15 of 30 from the floor. As I touched on earlier, the Hornets acquired guard Mucci Norris in cash considerations from Houston in exchange for center Marche Lampe. Norris had appeared in 29 games with the Rockets this season. The 8-year veteran has averaged about 5 points and 3 assists over his career. Lampe had played in only 2 games with the Hornets this season. We go to Oakland now for the NBA TV game of the night. Pau Gasol and the Grizzlies dropping in on the Warriors. Derek Fisher starting at the point for the injured Baron Davis. He's day-to-day with a sprained right ankle. Grizzlies up by one after one. And the bench for Memphis gets it going in the second. Bobby Jackson splashes a 3-ball. He had 7 in that quarter. 7 points, not 7 threes. That would have been some quarter. At some play, Akeem Warwick throwing down the oop from Jackson. Grizzlies up 7 at the half. Here's Jason Richardson now in the third, following a 3-point first half. Knocking it down right there from 3 range. The Warriors are running. Jason Richardson to Derek Fisher. He reels in a tough score to put the Warriors up 1. Fisher, 8 points in the third quarter. Again on the move. Zarko Kabarkova threading it to Ike Diagu. Warriors outscore the Grizzlies 25-11 in that third quarter. Warriors by 7 after 3. The final quarter is a seesaw affair. Gasol kicking it out. Bobby Jackson kicking it in. Memphis by 2. Warriors now down 2, 7.5 seconds to go and counting. Fisher taking it inside for the reversal. That looked easy against a good defensive club. He ties it at 79. Looking for the win. Gasol will get it. He will spin inside. He'll release. He'll get it to go. Beating the buzzer. Pau Gasol gets it off just in time for the Memphis Grizzlies to win this game in clutch fashion. 81-79. The Grizzlies take down the Warriors. Gasol finished with 23 points and 13 pulls. Derek Fisher scored 17 of his team high, 21 points in the second quarter. The Grizzlies won even though that 11-point third quarter of theirs matched their season low. And, of course, NBA TV is the place for live game action. Tonight we will be in Miami where the Heat will host the Orlando Magic. It's a Florida affair. Game time from American Airlines Arena set for 7:30 Eastern. We will see you then. NBA TV Daily returns with a trip to Target Center. That's where the Timberwolves look to get back on the winning track against the Raptors. See if they can snap a 3-game slide against a confident Toronto team. We'll be back with the moving pictures. Welcome back to the Daily with the NBA's big All-Star Weekend in Houston coming up. The NBA's Read to Achieve caravan, led by NBA legend Bob Lanier and numerous members of the NBA family, recently visited the youth of Houston to help spread the joy of reading. At each stop, the children had the opportunity to take part in reading timeouts with some of their favorite NBA legends and WNBA stars.
You know, it's always great when you have an opportunity to read your favorite book. You know, and I always find when you have a favorite book, read it all the time because you learn so much about that book, even from the first time you read it.
You were drafted in 1970?
Yes, sir.
You're old.
Thank you very much for that.
But when you get old, you want to be smart, right?
Yeah!
It's one way to get there, kids. Remember, reading is the key to everything that's cool in life. Now, I'm going to turn it back to you, Bob.
Give him a great big hand for the Gagarin! Thank you.
and I'm going to do some more reading now. Continuing with the theme of All-Star Weekend, Eva Longoria and Queen Latifah will coach some fellow stars at the McDonald's NBA All-Star Celebrity Game presented by 2K Sports. Others who will hoop it up at NBA All-Star Jam Session include Nelly, Nick Cannon, and Ice Cube. ESPN will televise the Celebrity Game as this Friday night, 7 p.m. Eastern. What an NBA All-Star 2006 is going to be this weekend in Houston. Well, coming off their most convincing win this season, the Toronto Raptors paid a visit to Target Center to take on the Timberwolves. On Sunday, Chris Bosh and company routed the Blazers by 33 points while shooting 59% from the floor. The Wolves, meanwhile, had lost three straight at home and six of their last seven games overall. Kevin Garnett and the Wolves desperately seeking victory. Here's Trenton Hassel with a drive. Who are you going to give it to? KG, who had 14 and 10 in the first half. Mike James, though, with the crossover, he'll pull up here. He had 11 in the first quarter, and Toronto led 27-24 after one. Then in the second, it's Jose Calderon out to Mo Pete. For Mo points and the foul, Toronto's lead is four. Peterson had 13 and a half, 20 in the game. Ricky Davis now inside to Mark Blunt, wide open. Get out of his way. Blunt 11 in the second quarter. Now it's Calderon swinging to Charlie Villanueva for the corner three. Villanueva had 10 in the quarter, Toronto by 5 at halftime, 53-48. Now in the third, Ricky Davis, call him Ricky Weaver, because that's what he does down the lane for the Jam. Now Mike James comes off the screen, he will lift a three ball. That is money after three. Toronto in good shape, up 77-70. KG and company need to make a move. Garnett in the post, backing down Chris Bosh. He'll turn around, he'll hit it, and the Timberwolves make it a two-point game, down 92-90, under 2 minutes. Trenton Hassel now will drive the lane. And he gets it to go off the glass. The Raptors lead 94-92, though. Now it's James splitting the D, and this is a big bucket. He ices it as the Raptors beat the Wolves 98-94. Toronto winning its third straight behind 20 from Mo Pete, 16 from the impressive rook Charlie Villanueva. The Raptors were 11 of 17 from three range, with Peterson a perfect 4-for-4. Overall, the Raptors shot just over 50% from the field. Now, Minnesota's Ricky Davis tied his season high with 9 assists, but Minnesota lost for the 11th time in its last 14 games and is now 2-19 when allowing opponents to shoot better than 45% from the floor. Speaking of the Raptors, their D-League affiliate, the Arkansas Rimrockers, were in action last night as well, and they came up with a win over the Fayetteville Patriots. The score there, 115-111. Lawrence Roberts led a balanced attack with 25 points, shooting 10 of 18. In the loss, Canyon Dickens had 13 for the Patriots. With the win, the Rimrockers move into a tie for fifth place with the Roanoke Dazzle. The Florida Flames still lead the pack. They have a two-game lead over Fort Worth and a two-and-a-half-game lead over the Austin Toros. There are two games on tonight's D-League schedule. Albuquerque will visit Fort Worth, and Roanoke will make the trip to Austin. We're not done with the highlights yet. Darius Miles made his return to the Portland lineup. We'll see how he and his Blazers fared against the Bobcats. And we'll have the best of the best in our daily top 10 as well. Don't move. The Charlotte Bobcats were home last night to take on the Trailblazers. Portland had been on a bit of a run recently, having won 7 of 11. Then came a fateful start to a seven-game road trip. The Blazers were 0-4 going into last night, with their last three losses by a combined 97 points. The Bobcats, meanwhile, had dropped back-to-back games after a franchise-best three-game win streak. Looks like the Bobcats, ready to rock, ready to roll. Zach Randolph gets the miss there and throws it down, so the Blazers' big man starts rolling early. The Bobcats get it to Raymond Felton on the inbound from half court to end the first quarter. Why not? On a 16-point night, that's a big bucket for Felton. The team was down 5 after 1. And the second, Reuben Patterson dishes to Darius Miles. Miles seeing his first action since December 2nd. Gets the big throw down there. Steve Blake inside to Victor Krapa, who throws it down. He had 11 points. Zach Randolph now to Juan Dixon. His jump shot is good. Blazers up 7 at the half. And the third, Bobcats. They'll swing it around. Jumaine Jones from 3-town. Blazers still up 7. Now it's Bernard Robinson picking off the Miles pass, and he takes it the other way to cap a 13-0 Bobcats run. They were down 2 after 3. So now we go to the all-important fourth. Sebastian Telfair to Miles. He gets lift for the throwdown. Portland's lead is 8. Now it's Zach Randolph muscling and scoring inside. And the Blazers win it by a final of 91-83 after losing their previous three games by 33, 32, and 32. The Blazers shoot 46% from the floor and get the road win. Darius Miles' return was a good one. 14 points on 7 of 13 shooting while playing 25 minutes. He had missed the previous 34 games after having right knee surgery. Revan Knight had 14 points and 9 assists, but he committed 7 of the Bobcats' 21 turnovers. And now it's our top 10 from Monday's action, beginning with number 10, Spurs Cavaliers, LeBron James, pumping up the baseline, going to the left hand. Same game for play number 9. Same guy, in fact. James cutting his way in for the monstrosity. Play number 8, Jazz Lakers. Smush Parker with the takeaway, the breakaway, and he's on his way somewhere. Nice play. Number 7, guess who? Smush again.
Kobe, what a look. Smush on the reverse. That'll bring him to their feet.
For play number 6, Rumble young man Raymond Felton.
Sebastian Telfair, 23-15. First quarter comes to an end on a Raymond Felton three-pointer from midcourt. Oh, my.
Play number 5, Spurs Cavaliers. Here's LeBron again going to work.
And Tony Parker will shift the last part of the quarter.
James came out of the attic with that dick hammer smack.
Play number 4. It's getting redundant.
James with a ripaway. LeBron in full flight. Flight number 23 exploded off the runway. And one coming. What a virtuoso performance from the megastar in wine and gold.
Play number 3. Grizzlies Warriors. Pau Gasol gassing it up.
Pau Gasol with the move and the bucket. And another crushing, frustrating loss for the Warriors.
Play number 2, the Wizards' Antoine Jameson stings the Hornets.
No good. Hayward tips it up. At the baseline. Yeah! Antoine Jameson with a dagger! And the Wizards go up by 1.
And play number 1, same game. Go West, young man.
The jumper by West.
The shot at the buzzer to drain the life out of the Wizards.
Come on, bring it.
And that's our daily top 10 from Monday nights. To check out the freshest NBA news, log on to NBA.com and go to the NBA Daily section. You can access the News Roundup, which gives you all the latest league news and information. You also can submit your email address to have the NBA Daily sent to you each and every day. And that is a wrap for this edition of NBA TV Daily. Don't forget the All-Star festivities in Houston are just days away. I'm Ron Burke. As we leave you here, last night's statistical leaders, have a great Valentine's Day.